We have seen that we can use contour integration even if our function has a singularity on the real axis. In that case, we will need to make a small indentation in the contour. In this video, you will see an explicit example of such an integral. This particular integral is called Dirichlet's integral. And it is the integral from 0 to infinity sine x over x dx. And you see already that you have a small problem at the origin. So if we want to use contour integration, what contour do we need to choose? Well, of course, we need to include L1 because we want to eventually to go from 0 to infinity. We have to close, so we have to start with some CR. But how are we going to close? Well, we need to go around the origin, so we need some part of 0. And then we have to think a bit ahead. Now we use something quite tricky. What we do, we're going to take a semicircle and we are going to include L2 as well. And that is a bit odd because we don't need the part from 0 to minus infinity. But we will also choose as our f of z e to the power iz over z. So those two together, the inclusion of L2 and the choice of f of z will give us our sine. Why do we choose this f of z? Well, we cannot include sine of z in our function because sine of z is going to blow up on our big arc CR. So we cannot do sine of z, so we have to do something else. E to the power iz will be fine. We'll be able to use Jordan's lemma later on, but e to the power iz is not sine z. But now comes into play the inclusion of L2, because on L1 we will have an e to the power ix over x, and later on L2 we will have a minus e to the power minus ix over x. And together they are going to give us e to the power ix minus e to the power minus ix equals the sine of x. So this choice of f of z and contour together is really quite tricky. It will work out later on, but you really you need to be a chess player, you need to think ahead quite a few steps to see how you are going to choose your function and your contour. Well, once you've chosen that, the other steps are, say, kind of standard. You always take the same steps. First steps, that one is the hard step. Choice of your total contour and your function f of z. But once we have it, we take the familiar second and third steps, etc. First of all, second step is easy. F of z is analytic on and inside the contour C total, which means that the total integral equals 0. It's either Cauchy-Gorsatz theorem or the theorem of residues. Then, step 3 will be a bit longer than in most cases. L1 is easy, you can just take z equals x, and the integral along L1 f of z dz, x will run from rho to r, plug in z equals x everywhere, you get the e to the power ix over x dx. L2 will be slightly more difficult, you take z equals minus x, and if you take z equals minus x, you start with your z at minus r and you go with your z to minus rho. So that means that x runs from r to rho. And then you plug in everywhere z equals minus x, so you get e to the power minus x, and here minus x, d minus x. So you see that minuses here and there are going to cancel out. You get an additional minus sign if you invert the order of the boundaries. So if you go from rho to r instead from r to rho. So if you take the two together, you go from rho to r, both of them. First one gave you e to the power ix over x dx, and the second one gives you a minus e to the power minus ix over x. And e to the power ix minus e to the power minus ix is exactly sine x times 2i. So there we are. That's the integral we want to have. End of step 3. Then step 0. We also need to parameterize that one because it does not go to 0. What are we going to do with our 0? We have to use the theorem. We have for f of z, 1 over z, we can make a Laurent expansion of the sine 1 plus, of the exponential function 1 plus iz plus 1/2 times I z squared, etc. We see that we have a simple pole for f of z. We observe that the coefficient of 1 over z equals a 1. So the residue at z equals 0 equals 1. Then we can use our theorem. We have a singularity right on the real axis. We go around it in a semicircle, so only halfway around it. And then our theorem tells us that if we take the limit rho to 0, then the contribution to the integral of 0 equals minus pi I times the residue at 0, so that equals minus pi I. And that's the contribution of 0. So we've done now the L1, the L2, and the 0. So we're only left with CR, and we will take that all in the last step, in the fourth step. Also here we need to be a bit careful with our 0. We cannot use an ML estimate over here. It decays too slow, but we can apply Jordan's lemma. If we set g of z equals 1 over z, then we know that norm of g of z equals 1 over r equals mr on the big circular arc CR. Then we can apply Jordan's lemma, because we know, Jordan's lemma tells us that if you take r to infinity, then the integral along CR, which is what we want, g of z e to the power a iz dz equals 0 if a is bigger than 0. Well, we have e to the power iz, so a equals 1, so that's okay. But we also need to g of z to be analytic for a set big enough. Well, g of z equals 1 over z, so that's fine. A CR needs to be a semicircle on the upper half plane. Okay, that's fine as well. G of z needs to be bounded by MR, and limit R to infinity MR needs to be 0. Well, our MR equals 1 over R. If R tends to infinity, this limit equals 0. We can apply Jordan's lemma, and the integral along CR vanishes. Now we have all contributions, L1, L2, 0, and CR, so we can wrap everything up in the final step. We combine integral L1 joint L2 plus integral along 0 plus integral along CR equals 0. So we can take those to the other side. So integral L1 joint L2 equals minus those two integrals. Then we take limits rho and r to infinity of the left hand side. That's over here. So we take limits to infinity r and rho of this one, which just gives us 2i times integral 0 to infinity sine x over x, which is the one we want. And we also take limits on the right hand side. So take rho to 0 and r to infinity on the right hand side. Well, this second integral over here will vanish due to Jordan's lemma, which we showed in step 4. This first integral along 0 equals minus pi I, as we showed in step 3. So we get a minus minus pi I equals pi I. So if we combine left hand side equals right hand side, we get 2i times r integral equals pi I, or r integral from 0 to infinity equals pi over 2. And there we have the result of Dirichlet's integral.